Hello and greetings from Iceland. I have a little thermal drone bonus for you in this volcano update where I will be speculating a bit about the magma hubs under the Reykjanes Peninsula and the next eruption that likely will take place within 6 weeks. And as many of you might remember, I was doing a thermal scan last year at this location by the Trölladyngja volcano. And now we have to bear in mind that this mountain, Keilir, it is directly above some kind of ancient magma pathway that fed the first three eruptions on the peninsula. And before those three eruptions, we could literally trace the magma from under Keilir and up to the surface. But what made the third eruption a bit different from the first two is the fact that for a while it looked as eruption number three would come up elsewhere as well or further to the northeast. So that area was off limits during the eruption and the weeks after it ended. And when the civil defense opened it again, it didn't take me long to go there with the thermal drone. And it took me even shorter time to find out that the ground around Trölladyngja volcano was extremely hot. And I made a few videos about it a year ago. And the Icelandic media picked up that story due to how unusual this was and is. But then we all kind of lost interest in this area when we got too busy to cover the next six eruptions in this old crater row by Grindavik. But those nine eruptions that have occurred so far, three by Mount Fagradalsfjall and the others by Grindavik, they are all from the same source, according to scientists. And now, while we are waiting for eruption number 10, we also see seismic activity on the rise by the mountain Fagradalsfjall. And furthermore, it's also at this place where I was scanning with the thermal drone last year. Just a few weeks ago, I noticed an earthquake swarm there and that made me do this second tour or to see if I could detect any changes since last year. And to make the results short and simple, I cannot say that the geothermal area is growing larger, but it seems as some parts of it are getting even hotter. So I used the chance to try out a little gadget that I bought recently to have in the car. And as I was on my way back, I did a little lookout tour, and that's when I found something new. We have an ancient volcano ridge 2.5 kilometers away from Trölladyngja volcano. It was glowing like a Christmas tree in the thermal camera. And I do actually have the same kind of shot from last year. And there was nothing like this to see there back then. So I did a little detour to this place to do a close-up flight. And I came back with this video. And I'm very sure that if this area was as hot as this last year, I would have noticed it because this was not my first thermal drone tour around there. But to be sure, I contacted Professor Þorvaldur Þórðarson and he told me that this area between Keilir and Trölladyngja is warming up. So this finding was not a total surprise, just a part of what has been going on there. And since I'm curious, and I will never get better from that, I used a tool that I'm linking to and looked at the earthquakes during the 2023 eruption by the mountain Little Rútur. And although I'm not in any position to be analyzing those data on a scientific basis, since I'm not a geologist, it doesn't take an expert to see the earthquake patterns. And it's a little fun fact that the place that has been warming up is exactly where the earthquakes that surely were indicating magma on the move during the 2023 eruption, they seem to have hit a bottleneck where the increased ground heat can be found now. So it's only logical to wonder if there is some kind of magma offshoot there from the 2023 eruption that is now warming up the surface. But I do, however, not see a reason to make this into a big issue. But I might, however, change my mind if the seismic activity that we can see by those old craters by Grindavík will continue to move back to the mountain Fagradalsfjall, where the first three eruptions took place. And that seems to be the case, actually, at least right now. So I'm of course wondering, will the next eruption or some of the next eruptions take place where all this started? And I'm also mentioning this because of an interview I found recently with Professor Þorvaldur, and he was saying that those events on the Reykjanes Peninsula, they could actually develop into a scenario where this ancient volcano shield called Þráinsskjöldur and covers a large part of the peninsula could simply wake up. And that would be a big thing and not good. Also meaning that what we have seen so far was just a practice, and it so happens that this question about this shield volcano coming to life again, I was talking about it several times in my oldest updates, because back then I had just learned that we had over 20 such formations on the peninsula alone, and the first three eruptions, they all took place very close to the top crater. All nine eruptions so far, they have been quite small, as for the volume of lava they produced. And it's not very hard to see through the visible lava layers on the peninsula alone what this area is capable of. So are we just looking at a cold start, Mother Earth cleaning some of the pipelines before she goes full force? And according to the professor, the answer is yes. Shield volcanoes can be decades in the making, and they drown anything in their way. And eruption of that kind near Grindavik would mean that we would not even find the lava berms again. But as for the next eruption, the Met Office seems to expect it to take place at the same old crater row, and the seismic activity there has been rising a little lately, and the Met Office is also expecting the eruption to be up to 30% larger than the last one, which is presumably a statistical analysis based on how things developed between eruptions 8 and 9. But they are not always right when it comes to predictions. They expected the last eruption to take place close to the town, but it was the other way around. The eruption was at the other end of this ancient crater row. And I have of course been looking at the earthquakes there recently, and I've been very surprised how many of the earthquakes in the region take place in the mountain Fagradalsfjall. And the 48-hour earthquake map looked like this today, or this unusual lineup from the central crater on this long crater row. And when we follow the earthquakes, we end up at the main crater from eruption number one. So I have of course been wondering, might we be looking at a similar scenario as we witnessed in 2021? Everything started with ground uplift under the mountain Thorbjörn, and for a while we expected the first eruption to take place near the town, close to the Blue Lagoon, almost under it. But then we got this shift and the mountain Fagradalsfjall ruled the show during the first three eruptions. So are we going there again? Is that possible? And what the professor said about the shield volcano is also saying that he thinks it's possible. And if that would be the case, that the activity is moving there, might the next eruption come up even further northeast than last year? Or perhaps close to the place where I've been flying the thermal drone? But I have not the answers to this. This is just what I've been observing, since that is after all my job. And right now my uneducated guess is more and less that the next eruption will be a continuation of the last eruption. It will start strong as always and might even cover the complete crater row by Grindavik end to end, but flaming out faster by Grindavik, just like last time. That would be the scenario that I would bet on. And that scenario would be good for Grindavik. But at the other end, we got lucky last time. And if the next eruption will stretch perhaps 2 kilometers longer to the northeast than the last one. That will put us in very difficult situation because there we have another town that could suffer the same fate as Grindavik, even worse. And we have also the busiest highway in Iceland there, and that is also the airport road. So this is very sensitive situation that we are in. But it is, however, too early to be go that deep into this now. As more magma accumulates and seismic activity intensifies, we might get some hints about the next eruption location. And we have, in fact, just 1 week or 10 days left of tension-free situation like we have had for the last weeks. And the reason is that the magma level in the magma chamber will reach the uncertainty threshold very soon. So after that, we Icelanders will get a bit more tense than we are today. Although it is considered to be likely that we will have to wait at least 1 month more. And if I were to guess what day it will be, I'm going to say December 1st. And it is of course my plan to film the next eruption with a new drone this time. But to film all those eruptions has been a bit complicated for me sometimes. I have to drive over 400 kilometers to get there when it starts. But I will do my best, of course. And I'm also hoping to get good conditions during that trip for yet another thermal scan. And I will be scanning a larger area between the mountain Keilir and Trollavinga. It's easy when it's cold outside and no sun. And believe me, we have plenty of such conditions this time of year. But before that, I will of course make several other volcano updates, since it's way more going on than I'm talking about in this video. So until my next video, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.